Hey guys, it's Vignesh from Code Android. In this video, we'll see about container. We can use this container as the background for the widget. Using this, we can give margin, padding, corners, elevation, and much more. To demonstrate this, I already created an empty Flutter project. In this, adding container as the child for the center widget. Using this color attribute, we can change color of the container. As I save the code, we can see the container color is changing to green. In case if you want to set width and height for the container, then we can use width and height attributes. By default, container will take its child width and height. When I give width as 100, container is taking only 100. In case if you want max width, then we can use double dot infinity. Similarly, for height also we can give double values. Here I'm giving 300 as the container height. Now we'll see how to add padding and margin for this. To see the changes, we need a child for the container. So adding another container as the child and making the child color as yellow. As you can see, inner child is covering the parent, which means container will take parent's width and height by default. For padding attribute, we need to pass edge inserts as value. For creating this edge inserts, we can use these options. Now I'm creating it with only option. So inside we need to provide the section where we need the padding. For example, left 10 and top 10. You can see now we are able to see the parent container at the top and left, because padding gives inner space between itself and the child. When we use all, we get space all the sides. We have another type called symmetric. When we use this, inside we need to pass either horizontal or vertical values. When we give horizontal spacing, then we get space at left and right side of the container. When we use vertical, we get the space at top and bottom of the container. Margin also accepting edge inserts, but it will give the space outside the container. You can see here we are getting space only on the left and right side, because center widget already given top and bottom space for the container. That's why we are not able to see it. Now we'll see about decoration attribute. As the name suggests, this attribute is used to decorate the container by adding border, elevation, and background images. For this decoration, we need to pass either shape decoration or box decoration. In this video, we'll see only about box decoration. For this box decoration, we can pass shape. Default shape of the decoration is rectangle. So I'm changing it to circle. When we save this code, we are getting an error, because Flutter is getting conflict between container color and decoration color. So we need to add either color or decoration. To set the decoration color, we can use box decoration's color attribute. So moving the color attribute inside box decoration, you can see our child is coming out of the container. So we need to be careful when we use circle as the shape. This will be helpful for adding borders for a circular image, etc. So temporarily commenting the child and adding border in the decoration. For border, passing border.all with width as 10 and color as red. Here also we have some options to create the border. But when we use symmetric for this, we are not seeing any differences, because circle doesn't have any vertical or horizontal sides. So changing the shape of the container to rectangle and saving the code. You can see now we are getting the border at the left and right side of the container. Sometimes we might need to give gradient colors for the background. In that case, we need to use gradient. So commenting the color and adding gradient attribute. For gradient, we can pass linear gradient or radial gradient. When we use linear gradient, we need to give colors in the array. Now I'm giving green and teal. You can see the background is starting from green and gradually changing to teal. If we add third color, in this case yellow, then it will act like start, middle and end color. Like this, we can give colors in an array to create the gradient. When we use radial gradient, the gradient created in a circular motion. If you want to load an image as a background, then we can use image attribute of the decoration. Also, there is a handy widget available for loading an image from the network. So, I'm using this network image widget for loading the image. You can see we got the image as the background. To add some curves to the container, we can use border radius. Note that this will work only on rectangle shape. I want to add curve on all the sides, so I'm creating the radius using border radius dot all, inside passing the radius as 10. You can see we got the curve on all the sides. In case if we want only one side to be curved, then we can use only. In this, we need to specify which corner we need radius. For example, top left. Finally, we'll see about shadow. To add shadow, we need to use box shadow attribute. For the box shadow attribute, we need to pass list of box shadow. So, creating an array, inside creating box shadow. For the shadow, setting the color as black, but when I save the code, we are not able to see any difference because we need to add some blur to it. To do that, adding blur radius as 10 and spread radius as 10. You can see we got the blur and elevation effect. I don't want the shadow to be on top and left side. To achieve that, we can add some offset to the shadow. So, adding some offset for the box shadow. You can see now we don't have any shadow on top and left side. Sorry, I forgot to mention another important property for the container. That is constraint. As the name suggests, we can add this to give constraint for the container. Adding min height as 100 and max height as 200. You can see the height of container is becoming 200, even though the height attribute of the container is 300. Because constraint will take more priority than inner attribute of the container itself. Similarly, setting min width and max width for the container. Like this, we can add some constraint to the container to avoid overlapping of other widgets. That's all for this video, guys. If you have any doubt, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.